by now he would be proficient in that. Any emergency he has, we have engine quit, he can land it.
Okay.
I guarantee. So you shouldn't worry about it.
Your first name is?
Ed.
Oh, Ed. Okay. He came from another flying school. Where this guy who hit the twin towers in your studies.
You mean in Florida?
You mean in New York? One of the schools in Manila, yes?
Okay.
Yeah, and then what you call this? It looked like parang it was not that good a school. So he moved into Omni, you know?
Yeah.
And I was informed that by next week he might be flying. And well, you told
he must
me,
be very excited by now.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. He does not text me. But anyway, now that I know you came from that school, then I'm a little bit more
yeah, we were one of the pioneers. In fact, most of those that I went to in flight school are now captains. Of major airlines now. We have Cebu Pacific, Airfield, Philippine Airlines.
Yeah.
So, in fact, I'm the only one who didn't pursue the flying career with the airline.
Okay. So I texted him and I told him you have to ask all the questions, especially on emergency.
Yeah.
But you told me since they're being trained on emergency.
No, they're trained very well. Yes, they're trained very well. And I know the owner very well.
Ah,
he used to be one of the top Philippine Airlines captains.
Okay. So, salamat, no? My other question, I hope you don't mind, Nicole.
No, not at all. Go ahead.
It's about the bags, no?
And the bags, yes.
Nahalata ko na, well, kasi I'm a bag freak, no?
Me, yes, also.
It's chocolate in Miss Mercado.
Hindi ka naman makalabas. So, ang nangyayari, parang I noticed that the material becomes crispy.
Yeah.
And I'm scared na it will... So how do I keep the bags not being crispy?
You have to expose them to air, but also you know you can buy those silica gel packs, but they're dangerous for pets and babies.
For babies,
so
yes.
It's more difficult. I find that it's more difficult to keep bags here with our weather than let's say when I lived abroad.
Weather.
Yeah, because of the humidity.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
The
yes.
problem here is that as soon as you leave the bags alone, you'll have humidity that's stuck. So the best thing to do is to have the silica gels.
Okay.
Or if you have a how do you say that? Dehumidifier,
mm-hmm.
or a in cameras, they have a storage box where that's controlled. The humidity is controlled.
So covering them with a plastic is also not good.
I would not recommend it. I would prefer that you cover them with also a cloth.
A cloth.
Exactly like my wife does. Everything's covered with cloth.
Okay.
So you don't have problems with humidity as well.
I see. Okay.
It depends also on the material of the bag.
Yes. If it's genuine leather, you'll have to buy a leather conditioner.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Regularly, especially if these are the expensive, very expensive bags, you'll have to have conditioners for them.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Mrs. Mercado.
Okay. Good day. Bye-bye.
Okay. Thank you, Mrs. Mercado. I love your questions. And the bags, you know, really.
Touched everyone's heart.
Yes.
It's a very basic concern.
They call me the bag lady at home. I think it's bags, shoes, and then my order of
makeup.
Past addictions. No, I don't use makeup. So thank God I can save money.
Yeah, imagine that. One less.
But I know a lot of women who like their makeup, and then they don't know where to keep it, and it's all over the place, you know. And I'm like, ugh.
Yeah.
But it's bags, shoes, and then I have a thing for jackets and caps as well.
Yeah.
Do we have another caller?
I'm not sure. Do we have another caller? No.
Let's go back to Ed.
Yeah. Let's go back to. Thank you for calling in, Mrs. Mercado.
Yes. Thank you, Mrs. Mercado.
Enjoyed that.
There was a you mentioned a distinction between a designer, an interior designer, and an interior decorator.
Yes,
that's right. So a designer is somebody again who has had training with the interiors of, let's say, a residence,
mm-hmm.
a condominium, a hotel, or a restaurant.
Mm-hmm.
What they do is very specific. Anything to do with moving walls, ceilings, tearing down ceilings, changing them to new.
Mm-hmm.
Putting additional lighting,
mm-hmm.
either on the walls, floors, or mm-hmm. ceiling. Basically, moving major items or let's say mirrors, you're adding mirrors, you're adding glass, you're mm-hmm. putting new doors. So it's that would fall under interior design.
Structural, electric.
Not specifically structural. Mm-hmm. It's more of decorative things. Like you have the ceilings.
Mm-hmm.
Some of the ceilings that you get, let's say, for condominiums are mm-hmm. very basic. Mm-hmm. What you want to do is to change them to do multiple type of ceilings.
Mm-hmm.
So that falls under interior design.
Mm-hmm.
But interior decoration is basically somebody who doesn't do anything mm-hmm. with the interior, keeps it intact, mm-hmm. but puts in all the furniture,
mm-hmm.
furnishings, all the decoration on the tabletops, mm-hmm. that's a decorator.
Can
they,
the decorator...
They sort of move things around mm-hmm. With furniture. That's a decorator.
Can they also apply paint?
A decorator would be mm-hmm. able to do that.
Mm-hmm.
But once you start tearing down and changing mm-hmm. the look, let's say, of the ceilings mm-hmm. or the walls, and the flooring,
mm-hmm.
then you would be considered
so
in the category of a designer.
A decorator is limited to the space provided by
space
the
space provided, mm-hmm. nothing changes, so everything is has to do with furniture and furnishing.
But an interior designer can add rooms,
add
dividers,
subtract,
or
mm-hmm. Basically alter mm-hmm. and change.
And right. the designers, the interior designers have, you know, there's a bit of coordination there with, let's say, an electrician or an electrical engineer.
Yes.
If you want to add a certain type of light, and you have to, let's say, inform the owner that if you want this kind of light, it's going to cost more. It's
yes, generally, blah, 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 generally blah. What we do is that we tell the client this is how your lighting would look like when mm-hmm. we design for them. But we tell them that we have to alter something specifics mm-hmm. with, let's say, the wiring.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Number one. Number two, the distribution panel,
mm-hmm.
the circuit breaker. So we generally calculate the loads.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
An electrical engineer would do that for us.
Mm-hmm.
So we refer that to the professionals.
Mm-hmm.
So they do the although we can do it ourselves, but we prefer that, you know, we pass it on first to an electrical engineer
mm-hmm.
to see if we've done the correct calculation.
Mm-hmm.
So once we've done that, we tell the client this is what we use. Halogen is being phased out.
Yeah, because
everything
it's
is LEDs
yeah.
now.
Mm-hmm.
So again, less and less load for mm-hmm. for most condominiums.